Looking forward to tonight. And as you were just saying, actually, Enny, as we were discussing at the break, it's just such an honour and a privilege for us to be watching a game featuring the likes of Messi.
It is, and you know, we've seen it already. You know, we've seen in the Champions against Man City the goal
Tuchel could have picked. Clement Turpin, our match referee tonight. PSG and St Etienne go head to head, looking for a place in the final four of the last ever Coupe de la Ligue. Neymar entered the box, took three to stop him, and stop him they did.
Oh, he fancied taking the shot on, it was great work. His key, so they'll try and start well and feel their way into a little bit of momentum and a little bit of confidence, but they must keep the clean sheet.
The way he loves to play this game of football.
Chance for Icardi. Well, it didn't take long, less than 2 minutes. Mauro Icardi gives PSG the lead with his 15th goal of the season. I think it was his first.
All right.
Little chip from him. Surprising effort. It's reading. Well, that's this corner too. There's Neymar. Years old. He's not going to forget his debut. Now Kira. PSG playing a very dangerous game in their own penalty area there.
Number.
Mbappe. PSG corner game the weekend. They won 6-0. Linus Montlieri hold them at bay. Otherwise, we could have another very one-sided scoreline here. Neymar's delivery. Touch behind Marquinhos. Moratti got their second time. Less exciting name of Idrissa Gueye. That's the missing link for them. Now, player down in the penalty area here. Oh, brilliantly done. Here come PSG again. Final effort from Mbappe. Moratti. Space for Trunco coming forward. Oh, Rico with the save. Kasri. Chance. And a regulation save. Sergio Rico.
Oh, that was better. Kept hold of the ball. They were brave. Committed.
Remarkable that he got in the top 30 in the first place. And he deserved to be there too. Now another foul on Neymar here.
Guess what?
Forward for the corner. There is Fofana. To come into the game after their early setback. Musa didn't quite control it. Rivera. Camara. I wish he could have another crack at. Here's Honora. They have to go alone. Well, he's won the corner. Kasri's delivery. One of his better corners, that.
He missed every screen there, didn't he? Decision.
And now they could be in big trouble. The referee's got a decision to make after that foul on Di Maria. It's only yellow, is it? But is it a second yellow? It is. Moratti's chip. Come back a club record if. He gets a goal tonight.
In behind.
Oh, Neymar. Brilliant. And that is 2-0. Well, if you give Angel Di Maria that amount of space, the chances are he's going to carve out a goal-scoring opportunity. Neymar, the player that took it with some aplomb.
Oh, that is sensational.
But apart from that, it's gone well. That is the way that Claude Puel has done it so far. The little flick from Mbappe. Oh, and very nearly an own goal, and it was eventually an own goal. It came off Loic Perrin, struck the post, struck the goalkeeper, hit Perrin again. Penalty area pinball, and everything is unravelling. Mbappe, Verratti, his shot charged down. Rivera goes for goal. And that will go down as a shot on target. Is Mbappe trying to find a way. Fizzeri after Wesley Fofana was sent off. PSG 3 Sunday night. The first time in, or the first of two games in what is very quickly becoming a very difficult evening. And the goalkeeper, he did the sensible thing, found Icardi, and he was never going to miss. And PSG now lead by 4-0.
Well, how unselfish that is from Kylian Mbappe. Even at his tender age of 21.
There, Icardi. Play continues. Oh, Bernat with a poor touch. golden opportunity, long second half for St Etienne as Kasri delivers the free kick. Neymar just went past the net, lucky wasn't even there. Moulin has to save at the feet of Mbappe.
Just got to be careful, he doesn't do too much because that might happen.
There's Debuchy, well, he's on the yellow card.
He's got to go.
If Mbappe, here's Icardi, and there's the hat-trick. Mbappe so unselfish once again. And Mauro Icardi is the man to benefit. Round of applause from Edinson Cavani too. Now Mbappe. Moulin committed himself, but just in the face that Mbappe has got here, is he going to get the goal for himself this time? Moulin with a save. You can see him on that group. Now, Neymar just wide. Bernat again. Juan Bernat. Oh, just wide. The live game, which is Palace Arsenal, as Mbappe tucks away goal number 6. And he does get his name in the record books.
Well, it was only a matter of time. It's been sensational, the youngster tonight.
Here.
Oh, that's a penalty.
It is indeed a penalty. Kabay. Oh, he saved it, Rico. But the rebound is put in by Johan Kabay. St Etienne.
Av årets Ligue 1-sesong fikk Strasbourg 11 poeng fra 3 seire og 2 uavgjorte, og ble dermed rangert på 13. plass. Den prestasjonen er mye bedre enn St Etienne. Det nye laget eier 4 poeng og rangerer laget, selv om det kun er 2 poeng bak det sikre området. Er det vanskelig for St Etienne å forbedre seg i det minste etter møte med Strasbourg i runde 10? Dette er fordi de ikke antas å vinne, selv står overfor en stor risiko for å falle. Tomhendt scene, og måtte være gjest gjør St Etienne svært nær dødsdøren til denne kampen. Skulle vite. Laget under trener Claude Puel har lidd nederlag da de kom til Strasbourgs felt i de siste 2 Ligue 1-sesongene. St Etienne selv er for tiden i dårlig form på bortebane. De siste 3 turene hjemmefra ble Blue Devils, alle dempet, mot henholdsvis Marseille, Montpellier og Monaco. De skåret 2 mål, men slapp inn 8 ganger i denne kampen. I mellomtiden viste Strasbourg nylig et veldig lyst ansikt på Rede, Stade de la Meinau. I de siste 3 hjemmekampene beseiret hæren til strategen Julien Stefan Brest og Metz. Der hver kamp skåret 3 mål, resten var et 1-2 tap mot den forsvarende mesteren Lille i sammenheng med å miste folk på grunn av det røde kortet. Ifølge fotballdommen i kveld er vinnerdøren for Strasbourg relativt åpen. Dette betyr at å velge Strasbourg med et handicap på -0 og en kvart vil være tryggere for asiatiske publikummer enn de fleste.